Academic integrity is important for many reasons. When students think of academic integrity, they usually think of getting in trouble. Academic integrity has a negative meaning in many students' minds. But academic integrity is really about making good decisions about your academic work so you can be prepared for success in college and in your career. When you complete your work honestly, you are gaining all the knowledge, skills, and attitudes that will ensure your success in your future courses at Sheridan and beyond. When you engage in cheating, you are gaining an unfair academic advantage over the other students in your courses who work hard to learn the subject matter and to earn their grades. When you engage in cheating, you are not showing the proper respect to the students or to the professor. As well, you are not taking responsibility for your own learning, and you're showing that by taking the easy way out, you are not to be trusted. Lastly, you are cheating yourself because you are missing out on gaining valuable study skills and work habits, which are essential throughout college and at work. This is the definition of academic integrity. As you can see, it isn't about punishment, but rather it's about doing the right thing. Think about each of these values and reflect on how you can demonstrate each during this course, during your time at college, and once you have graduated. If students cheat in this course, they usually do one or more of these things. They copy code from the internet, help other students when it's not appropriate, or they purchase work and submit it as their own. Another way students can cheat in an online environment is when they have someone else take a test for them. That is, they have someone else impersonate them. First, they copy code from the internet, from websites such as StackOverflow.com or from tutorials and homework sites. Sometimes they cheat by simply copying the professor's posted code examples and trying to pass them off as their own work, hoping the professor won't notice. If you want to use code from the internet, ask your professor. If you want to use anything the professor has posted, ask permission first. Once you have confirmed that code from these sources is okay to use, make sure to properly explain the code in your own words so that the professor knows that you fully understand the code you copied. Also, be sure to cite it properly. Second, even though it's good to help people in general, you need to watch that you don't cross the line into cheating. For instance, students cheat when they help each other by either directly copying another student's code or asking the student if they can show you how they completed their code. Some students will try to edit another student's code to make it look like their own. Did you know that the student who provides the code is also considered to be cheating, just like the student who copied? Copying is always a bad idea, since the teacher is able to locate where the code came from. Third, students cheat when they pay someone to complete their work for them. Be aware, if you pay someone to complete your assignments for you, then submit it as your own. This is called contract cheating, a serious breach of academic integrity. Contract cheating is considered serious because someone else is completing the entire assignment and the student is not learning anything or practicing important skills. Students can also cheat by having someone else complete an online test or exam for them, such as another student, a friend, or a relative. This is called impersonation, and like contract cheating, it's a serious breach of academic integrity. You know about the typical types of cheating that can occur, but you may be asking yourself why. The majority of students have good intentions and never plan to cheat, but sometimes they find themselves in situations where they think there's no other choice. There's always another choice. For instance, students may be feeling a lot of pressure to succeed from their family or their schoolmates. They may be stressed because they have so much work to do and not enough time. They may leave things to the last minute, or they may think the work is too difficult and they just can't do it. But it's not worth the risk. Of course, the work you encounter at college will be challenging, but engaging in this work and doing your best helps you grow, and as mentioned previously, it helps you become successful both in college and once you graduate. When you do your own work, you are able to learn from your mistakes and gain confidence in your abilities. As well, if you're caught cheating at the college, there are consequences. You could end up with a zero on the assignment. If you continue cheating, the consequences become more severe, including an F in the course, suspension, and even expulsion. Besides grades, cheating can impact your chances of getting a co-op placement or a job after graduation. If you do find a placement or a job, the consequences of cheating in college continue once you are working, and now the consequences are even more serious. If you cheated in your courses, you missed valuable learning opportunities, and you're not going to be able to complete the required work satisfactorily. This can lead to letting down members on your team and could lead to getting fired. Instead of resorting to cheating, if you're feeling pressure, stress, if you feel you lack time management skills, or if you feel you are not capable to do the work, help is available. You can talk to your professor and let them know what's going on. Perhaps your professor can provide extensions or resources that can help you academically. You can ask the Java Learning Assistants in Tutoring for one-on-one Java help. Also, these learning assistants run a one-hour session each week where you can ask questions about Java and get help. Student Advisement is the place to go for any questions you may have related to getting support. If you struggle with time management, you can make an appointment with a learning assistant in Tutoring for help with managing time. Complete the time management module to learn some helpful strategies. Good luck with your studies, and just know that help is always available.